like I said, Rough Janet, Riders, how are you? Buck fan, and teddy bears, beads. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to the show, guys. Now, this is a rowdy crowd right here. You guys are tearing it up the whole show. Trying to keep quiet.
Before we talk to Buckify,
I just want to make sure you understand why we're together, too, because John Winter and worked with me at WFLA-TV.
Oh, yeah, we got that.
Okay, all right.
But I want them to introduce their friends.
Let's introduce everybody.
All right.
Okay, I'm Ben Kelly.
Ben Kelly.
Phil Saladino, incoming president of the Rough Riders.
Bill.
Wow.
Dan Ulrich.
Dan. And who are you?
I'm Buckify Burke.
The guy with the boat on the head?
Yeah, I'm the South Division heavyweight champion of the world, Buckify Burke.
Okay, Buckify, you got me on this one. All right, let's not talk about that right now.
Let's talk about the teddy bear roundup that Johnny, like Buckify alluded to earlier, that Johnny, did he start it with you guys and you're carrying on the legacy? How did that work and why are you doing this?
Well, the Rough Riders were originally founded in 78 and we were always involved in a lot of teddy bear runs, but it wasn't until John kind of started the drive with Channel 8. He started working with Channel 8 and giving us the publicity. And it's been really, really successful, and it's taken off like gangbusters.
Now, what do you do with the teddy bears, and when do you collect them?
Well, we, about once a month, from January through November, we go out on teddy bear runs, and these can be in anywhere from Key West to Tallahassee Mobile.
Different chapters?
These are all our Rough Riders.
Oh, really? So you guys go travel? Go down there?
Oh, I bet you they probably have houses down in the Keys or friends and all that stuff. So
I wish we did.
We all ride Harleys?
No, not all of us.
I got a wannabe.
So then you gather these up every month?
We do the runs every month, but in the month of December, we have our drive. And also during the month of December, we have about 18 to 20 teddy bear runs. And those are in various hospitals throughout the community, orphanages, nursing homes, homeless areas, metropolitan ministries, stuff like that. So there's a big demand for them.
Do you guys have a website where people can go on to find out the information so they can be part of these teddy bear runs and be part of this whole event that happens?
Well, the only time really that we involve the general public is usually Christmas Eve. Okay. And a lot of those are from various crews throughout the committee throughout the community. There are probably about 20 different crews, as you know, who participate in Gasparilla.
Yeah.
And a lot of the their members come and join us on our teddy bear runs on Christmas Eve because we do about six to eight.
That's great.
Okay, all right. I missed the point there for a second.
That's okay.
I apologize. I thought y'all just get together and everybody brings a teddy bear that you guys go cruising somewhere and come back.
An office that picks a project each Christmas, and they pick support us. You wouldn't believe a 20-person office collected over 450 bears for us, and other people in the public get involved with collecting them, and then they see us on the TV giving them out, you know, and they get excited about, there's our bears, you know. Really gets good Christmas spirit for people.
Now, Phil, you're continuing this legacy in Johnny's name. Do you want to, this is the first... You want to embellish on that?
I can barely hear you, but no.
I said you're continuing Johnny's legacy.
Oh, yes, for sure. This is legacy. It's to know John is to love the guy. He's the only guy you can have the worst day in your life, and just talk to you for 30 seconds, you forget what your problems are. We had this little thing at the parades. You look for the guy with no hat, that's John. No, but he's talking about last night we sorted out over 8,000 stuffed animals.
Wow. That's a lot. That's enormous.
Animal stuff.
Huge success,
yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. We got a Gaither High School, over pretty close to 5,000, giving an example.
We're almost running out of time. So for our listeners, before we get to Buckified, where can people drop off teddy bears to help you guys out with your...
George Buckified.
You can find out all the drop-off locations by going to Buckify.com and John Winter. There's a link next to John Winter name on my front page. And now the link, you're right to tbo.com, where your keyword is teddy bear. But Buckify.com, got it down on the front page. And then you can come to News Channel 8 and drop off bears over there. And all the locations you can find
I imagine your lobby is full of teddy bears
right now. It is so beautiful.
What's going to happen Sunday at 4?
This Sunday when we play against, well, you know now that we beat well, I ain't gonna say crap, but I mean, you know, we
Michael Vick,
we sure did.
Well, it was Vickless and it was coachless and everything. I mean, I don't blame the coach for you know not wanting to come and see, get a whooping like what we put on the Atlanta Falcons.
That was a whooping.
I mean, you know, we really put it on the Atlanta Falcons. And this week we're playing the 49ers, and we won't be kind to them at all. Buccaneers will take it to the 49ers, 28. They'll get 10 points. And the only reason they're going to get 10
that
points.
That seems to be a very common theme with you, that 10 points for the opponent team.
That's what kind of defense. You know, you get after you put it on them, you get in a prevent defense, and you let them get a few points, you know, just to not make it look so bad.
Well, they look good against the Atlanta Falcons, although I think my flag football team might have been able to beat them, too.
Yeah, but at the same time, make sure you see the hat now. The hat says South Division champ. The next hat you're going to see is the NFC championship, and then you're going to see the Super Bowl champion. But I told you we were going to start on Del Mabry Corner. The destination is the Super Bowl in Arizona. We're in the Super Bowl tournament now.
We want to thank you all for coming out. Thank you very much. You got a great little concert while you guys got to watch.